respond?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, it's in the day. I mean, you know, we're not going to hide anything. If it's good, we'll tell you. If it's bad, we'll tell you. And we rolled out the 5-year plan the other night. $3.9 million deficit. Not good news. We don't know about it, so we're going to attack it. We'll go at it, you know, day by day. I know Joe's work ethic is basically the same my work ethic now. I mean, there's proper protocols to go through. There's some things we'll be able to tell you very quickly, and there's some things I'll have to say no. We can't tell you that right now because we don't have a definite answer. And there's some things you keep close to your vest until it's time to tell people. But no, I mean, we'll be there. I mean, I plan on coming to every city council meeting. The managing director will be at every city council meeting, others around town. No, I mean, we'll work together. We want to work with council. Council, you know, I come back to my own strong council, strong mayor, strong administration, strong council. It's a win-win.
Well, it's refreshing to hear, and this is what we feel is going forward now. And I welcome you.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Hendricks. Thank you, Mr. President. Good evening. Mr. McMahon, I got to say it's very refreshing and comforting to know that we've interviewed quite a few managing director appointees to be in the past, and I believe you're the first one who is homegrown. You lived here, you live here now, you work for the city, your children went to school here. That's not a small thing for me. I think it's very important for someone who has knowledge of the area. And you kind of ask the question, which I'm concerned about too, is the culture that's been created here over the last couple of years. And quite frankly, it's a culture of deception. And I think in speaking to the mayor up till now, and as he assured most of us, there'll be an open door policy and that we can speak to bureau heads without having to go through you. And if it's something is important enough that he needs to know about, that's fine. But up till now, we were never allotted that opportunity. Many of them would speak to us, I can say that now, but it was like, again, it was a culture where we were treated, we as council, as second-class citizens. And the previous administration didn't realize that, you know, the mayor's on this level of the organizational chart, and city council on that same level, but we were down here. And I think, too, that was something that was pushed on all the employees of the city, too. And I'm not saying they took it that way, but they were made to realize that that's what the previous administration wanted. So I would just say that open and honest and transparent is my most important value that I want to see from you going forward. And I would hope that you're able to do that and hold to that.
That's my value.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Hendricks. Mr. Greed,
thank you. Thank you, Mr. President. Yes, another question that I had that had been answered already, but I want to welcome you and thank you for seeking this appointment, and also to Mayor O'Connell for bringing you in. Just got a couple of few questions. First of all, like Mr. Hendricks indicated, I'm very delighted to see that you actually live in the city of Allentown, and you know the people, know a lot of the people in the city. You worked for the city for quite a long time, and I have two questions. One of them was already alluded to, but I'll ask the other question first. And it's in regards to, you made a lot of friends in the city. You made a lot of friends with some of the employees that are still here. And we have a history of, because of the previous administration, having favoritism to some employees and not to others, to the extent that some people were promoted or demoted or actually fired if they can get along with the former managing director, allegedly, let's say that, okay? And I heard that kind of situation going on. What will you do? What would be your leadership style? How will you manage all these people and be as level-headed as possible without favoritism and at the same time, comforting?
I think one of the first rules of labor relations is, and as well as law, is you treat all equal. There are rules, and we follow the rules, and you treat everyone equal under those rules. And I can give you a perfect example from probably 25 years ago. If there was an employee who was a problem,
brothers can tell you that. When I sat my supervisors down, I said, you do not specifically go after that person. You do your job as you're supposed to. And if that person's not doing their job, then eventually it will show. But this is not a witch hunt. This is about treating everybody equally, making sure everyone's doing the same job correctly. And that's all.
Thank you. I got another question. Another question that was alluded to by Mrs. Zuko, Councilman Zuko, and that's in regards to LCA, Java LCA. And, and as you know, obviously, many people are concerned. I was in radio station this morning with Spanish radio station with McKenna, and we spoke about, you know, with the meeting tomorrow and what the LCA proposal is. And that's obviously, as we look at it and as I understand it, it may affect a lot of individuals if we go to in a monthly basis billing system. Which may cost $156 per year, at least. And it may be really difficult for us to get into this situation. Because of your relationship with them, how can you assure us that you are gonna be advocating for our city to the most and for the residents versus your relationship and previous employment? And how can you help us to make a better deal?
I do pay where it's real, so it's going to cost me extra money just to start with. But look, I would imagine I can't, and I haven't spoken with council, but I imagine I probably shouldn't say too much about it because there is a possibility of litigation, so you don't want to prejudice the city's view.
That is that.
I enforced the 81 and the 86 sewer agreements when I was manager of water resources. Matter of fact, I had to find an industry out in the suburban communities $100,000. And they paid it within the 30 days were required. When I went to LCA, I actually worked with that industry cooperatively. There was an agreement, this is what it said, this is what occurred, this is the solution to it. This isn't about our egos or anything, this is about what's the right thing to do. And eventually, I have to tell you, some of the people who worked for me were a little nervous about, you know, doing that. In the end, there was no problem. 30 days, check was paid to the city, $100,000 for that line. I went out there, I worked with those people just as well. Because we had a job to do, and we do our job correctly. You know, obviously, I've lived in the city, I've worked for the city. I'm going to defend the city if I believe the city's right. But I think the first thing you have to do with people we do is look at the facts. What do the contracts call? What are the facts? And evaluate those. And obviously, I'll sue it with Mayor Connor and do that. And then we'll come to some reasonable conclusion about what we need to do. But I can assure you, I'm not, because I worked for LCA for 7 years, doesn't mean I'm going to give in to whatever they think they need if it's not within the contract in the best interest of the city. I think there's a lot of good people who sit on LCA's board. There's a lot of reasonable people. We have a lot of reasonable people. Hopefully, reasonable minds can come together and find a solution. Yeah, there's legal issues. But let's face it, there's people there that's probably on both sides that want to see a reasonable resolution. I hope that covers your answer.
It does, and I don't want to get too much into it because there's a possibility of litigation. However, you know, I want to make sure that we are in the same page in regards to that issue, as we know that, you know, as it was posted to us, to Ms. McKenna and I this morning by Spanish radio station, who said, look, are they doing this on the signatories? Are they doing it at the other municipalities? And they went down to exactly no. And then they said, well, most of the people who live in Allentown, a lot of the people who live in Allentown are poor people and can defend themselves. And it is our responsibility to defend all our residents in our city to make sure they don't pay more than what they should be paying. So that, I leave it up to you. You don't have to answer that. Just thanks. Saying that as a comment. Okay? So thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Greedy. Open it to the public.
Yeah. Thank you, Mr. President. Who heard my fourth prime word, Gilmore Street, Appleton, Pennsylvania. Mr. Duco, I missed a Grady Rage Good Issue, LCA. Can you find out from Mr. McMahon if he knew anything about the lease agreement being negotiated? Was he involved with Dan Kovich in putting the lease agreement together? Didn't Dan, when you're a good friend of Dan, you work for Dan, if I'm looking for pricing. Did you have any involvement in putting the lease agreement together?
No, from the city's perspective?
LCA.
Oh, okay, the LCA did not put it. Let's clarify. When the city put it out to bid, they had documents that everyone bid on. Right? So the city prepared them with all the consultants, of which Dan Kovich was one of them. Now, I had nothing to do with preparing the city's documents.
No, for LCA.
Right. Yeah, and I just wanted to clarify for everyone.
When you put in a bid, I mean.
Yes. Was I involved in putting in the bid? Yes.
See, this is my big concern. I hope, since you are involved, you were involved, and we have problems that you read in the morning call today. They're not in the best financial condition any authority can be in. Is there any way we can get out of this lease agreement that we're in now? Because it seems
that's a lawyer issue. That's a lawyer issue.
I know. Yeah, but he might put it together. Maybe he
can. No, we're not going to put that question in. That's a legal issue. That's for court.
You submitted it.
What's that?
You did help. You just submitted it.
Well, we know that, but you're asking them how to get out of it. That's for lawyers to decide.
We don't want to put that in. Yes. Out in the public.
I do have a concern, sir. My concern is that the homeowner, at least some years now, and Mr. McMahon just now is $10,456. I'm sure Joe, Mr. McMahon is $10,000 more than that. The financial condition they're in, and the borrowed money that they have to borrow is going to be in the premium. So I hope that we can use him and Dan Kovich more and more and see how we can either slide out of this agreement or improve the agreement that we have now to benefit the homeowners and property owners and all this is now. There's not a bright future with LCA, and we have to see how we can improve the future. And I thank you, Ed, for disagreeing to bring that issue up. Thank you.
No, that's a professional.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Again, I'm going to go back to the point that we need to understand what the contracts are, our responsibilities are, right? Because we owe that to the citizens of Allentown. That's our duty. We need to understand what LCA's responsibilities under that contract are. Now, obviously, the difference between those is what has caused the problems that are going on now. Apparently, I don't know all the details. But understanding what the basis of the agreement is, and then being able to maybe find a solution that helps everyone.
Excuse me a minute. Excuse me. Sir, the sign out of council chambers. Thank you. All right, I'm sorry to interrupt.
Anyway, as I was saying, we need to understand the facts of the contracts and work from there. We don't want LCA to fail, right? Because then that puts onus back on us. At the same time, I'm sure they don't want us to fail. So if there's a place where we can meet that helps them and us, hopefully we can find that sweet spot.
Yeah, same Joe. Mr. McMahon, there's got to be a lot of need on both sides. But we read the same paper what you brought out before and the rate increase and understanding and all that. Thank you.
Hello. Ellen Hahn, 2016 East Highland Street, Allentown. I have a question. Is the city treated the same in this contract as the outlying districts? I feel like the city is not treated the same. The gentleman said the facts. We always hear just the facts, but we don't get the facts. So the question is, why are we treated differently, or aren't we?
Okay, this is a confirmation hearing for Mr. McMahon. That's not his purview.
He's going to be involved in that setback question, isn't he?
Well, he will be involved in it, yes.
And like he said he's answered it. He said he's going to try and work together with LCA. It's to everybody's benefit if both entities can work together and come to a reasonable resolution to it.
All right, so there's no way to answer that at this time?
Not at this time. That's getting closer to Lou's question about that might wind up in court, so.
Do you have a feeling that it could ever get answers, or you don't want to say?
We're definitely going to get answers, just not tonight in the confirmation hearing.
Okay.
Sure. This is a confirmation hearing for Joe McMahon for managing director.
When does the meeting start?
After we're done with the confirmation hearing, and we take a 5-minute recess.
Oh, thanks.
Yep. Anybody else for? From the public regarding the confirmation hearing for Joseph McMahon for managing director. Seeing nobody. Mr. Mayor, anything final from you, and then we'll go to.
No, I just think Joe is a good fit for Allentown, and I think moving forward, there's a lot of questions about obviously LCA, the agreement, and all. Tomorrow night is the first step. I'll be making a statement on behalf of the city. Hopefully, as many members of City Council come out, because your job and my job is to protect the residents and the citizens of the city of Allentown, and that is stay with quarterly building, not going to monthly building. And I'll make a statement tomorrow night.
You'll have support there, Mayor.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mr. Hanlon, over to you.
Okay, this resolution reads that council hereby approves the appointment of Mr. McMahon as managing director at a salary of $110,000 a year, effective Monday, June 4th. Ms. Apa?
Yes.
Mr. Greeny?
Yes.
Mr. Hendricks?
Yes.
Ms. Moda?
Yes.
Mr. Robinson?
Yes.
Mr. Zupa?
No.
Mr. McMahon?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you. Welcome aboard, Mr. McMahon. All right, we're going to take a 5-minute recess, and then we will be back for our council meeting.